Leanne Putney, Trauma Program Coordinator at Sarasota Memorial Hospital. While we are fortunate to have a great trauma center in our community, our goal is to help you stay safe while having fun. These are my top 5 tips to keep you and your family safe and injury-free this summer. Number 1, beat the heat. We live in a tropical paradise, but it's important to recognize how dangerous the summer heat can be. Hydration is key. Make sure you drink lots of water, wear sunscreen and protective clothing, and try to stay out of the sun between the hottest hours of 10 a.m. and 4 p.m. Never ever leave a child or a pet alone in a car, even for just a few minutes. The temperature can quickly rise to dangerous levels. Leaving a child in a car is not always intentional. Some tragic accidents have occurred when parents or other caregivers are out of their usual routine. In this situation, reminders can help, like putting your purse or cell phone in the back seat with the child. Number 2, water safety. Drowning is the leading cause of preventable death for children 1 to 4 years old. Enroll your child in age-appropriate swim lessons, but don't let your guard down, even if your child is a strong swimmer. Make sure you always have a designated water watcher. It's common to have many adults sitting around the pool, but they are talking to one another, and no one has that commitment to always keep their eyes on the kids in the water. Contrary to what most people think, children who are drowning do so very quietly. If they come to the surface, they struggle to get a breath in rather than shouting for help. Often adults are close by but don't realize the child is in trouble. You can prevent this tragedy by using a water watcher badge, such as this one, to assign one adult to be vigilant and train off frequently so that everyone gets to have fun and the kids stay safe. Lastly, if you don't already know how, learn hands-only CPR. Attend a community event, or you can Google hands-only CPR, and you will find a 1-minute video on how to perform this simple but life-saving technique. Number 3, avoid rip currents. Rip currents are narrow channels of fast-moving water that can move at speeds of up to 8 feet per second, which is faster than an Olympic swimmer. There are several clues to help you spot a rip current at the beach. Areas of darker water where waves do not break, flanked by areas where waves are breaking, may indicate a rip current. It may also have a dirty or muddy appearance from sand being transported away from the beach, or you may be able to see water or seaweed rapidly streaming away from the beach. Often, people panic when they find themselves being pulled out to sea and try to swim straight back to shore, putting themselves at risk of drowning from exhaustion. Rip currents do not pull you under, only farther away from the shore, and they will eventually stop. If you are caught in one, stay calm and focus on keeping afloat until you can break free from the current by swimming parallel with the shore until you are out. After you are out of the current, swim at an angle away from the current and towards the shore. If you are unable to reach shore, wave your arms and yell for help while staying calm and floating or treading water. Number 4, know how to get out alive if your car is submerged. We are surrounded by water in our community, and our community has had several recent tragedies where a car ends up in a body of deep water and occupants were unable to escape. The old advice to wait until the car is completely submerged and the pressure equalizes so that you can open the door is no longer considered the best way to get out. Here's what to do instead. Immediately upon entering the water, get your seatbelt off, roll the window down, and escape through the window. In the event that you cannot release your seatbelt or cannot open the window, keeping a device such as this one within arm's reach in your car at all times can be life-saving. This combination tool can be used to cut your seatbelt and break the window and is available online for less than $10. Number 5, don't get burned. Fireworks are beautiful, but best left to the professionals. According to the U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission, each year, several people die, and tens of thousands are injured badly enough to require medical treatment after fireworks-related incidents. The best advice is to stay away from all consumer fireworks and to only enjoy fireworks at public displays conducted by experienced professionals. Just because fireworks are legal to purchase does not mean that they're safe. Most parents don't realize how dangerous sparklers can be. Sparklers burn at about 2,000 degrees and can quickly ignite clothing or cause severe burns if dropped on feet, as the metal rods can take several minutes to cool down. Sparklers cause approximately 25% of hospital emergency room visits for fireworks-related injuries, the largest of any single type of fireworks. Many children are also injured when stepping on a sparkler or picking up a sparkler, which is still hot enough to cause a burn. If you choose to use them, fireproof gloves can help to protect hands. Make sure to always wear closed-toed shoes to protect feet. Don't ignite more than one sparkler at a time, and put spent sparklers in a bucket of water or sand.